Let's talk about Earth's magnetism. To know the Earth's magnetism, you must study three elements of Earth's magnetism. The first one is declination, second, the inclination. This is also known as dip. The third one is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. So let us discuss one after the other. So in that, first let's talk about the declination. To understand the declination, first of all, you must know some terms related to the Earth's magnetism. Normally, when we keep the compass needle or when we suspend any magnet, it comes to rest in north-south directions. But in fact, it does not exactly come to rest in north-south direction, but it makes certain angle. The line joining the north-south poles is called magnetic axis. Earth is a giant magnet, and if you imagine a pseudo magnet that is inside the Earth, then it will also have north and south poles. But here, if you consider that this is geographic north and this is geographic south, then the pseudo magnet's south pole exists in geographic north. Similarly, Earth magnet's north pole exists in geographic south. So here also, when we connect this geographic north and geographic south, you can get a line. This line is called geographic axis. So we talked about the magnetic axis and geographic axis. The plane which contains this magnetic axis is called magnetic meridian. So it is the plane contains the magnetic axis. Similarly, there is geographic meridian. It is nothing but the plane contains geographic axis. Once you understand these terms, then it is very easy to define the declination. So declination can be defined as the angle between the geographic axis and magnetic axis, or the geographic meridian and magnetic meridian. To make it clear, I have taken a model. Let's consider that this ball, plastic ball, is Earth, and this red straw is representing the geographic axis. Then this green straw is representing the magnetic axis. When we observe these two, there is an angle between these two. So that angle is only known as declination. We can imagine a plane which is passing, a vertical plane which is passing through this geographic axis, which is called geographic meridian. Now you can imagine this is the plane. This should be placed here. So this is the geographic meridian. Similarly, you can place another plane which is magnetic meridian. So The angle between these two planes is known as declination. So, see, you can see that there is some angle between these two. Geographic axis and magnetic axis are the angle between geographic meridian and magnetic meridian.
Let's now visualize the declination. The line joining the North Pole and South Pole of the Earth is called geographic axis. The plane which contains this geographic axis is only known as geographic meridian. Now, when we suspend freely any magnet, it does not exactly coincide with this axis, but it tilts with certain angle, and that angle depends on the particular place at which the bar magnet is suspended. This is magnetic axis, and the plane on which this magnetic axis is there is called magnetic meridian. We can define the declination as the angle between geographic axis and magnetic axis, or the angle between geographic meridian and magnetic meridian.